Hello people, welcome to this tutorial. I will show you here the basis of Adobe Illustrator CC in a single shot. We will have a general overall idea about how to use it. If you are looking for something in detail, check the quick index in the description. First of all, Illustrator is a graphic software to make and edit any kind of art project and design. To open a new file, go to File and then to New. Use in the future the Open option to open any design project under the Illustrator file project.ai. After clicking New, a new window will show up to set the properties of your basic workspace. Give it a name, width and height at the bottom. The Size section sets the standard values for the width and height. The artboards you see are like sheets of blank paper. If you have more than just one, you can set each of their position. Then you can use orientation to exchange the values of width and height. When deciding, go to OK. Here's where you will start. Let's have a look at how to put and edit shapes on your workspace. On the very left side of the software, you will find the Tools panel. In case you don't find it, it means that it's hidden, so you will need to open such window. Whenever this happens, go to Windows section and tick on the window closed, in this case the Tools one. The Tools panel is one of the most important sections of Illustrator, from which it is possible to draw segments, polygons and other kind of shapes. Let's start with a rectangle. You will see that its button has one corner colored in white. This means that the button is hiding other options, similar to the one showed by the button itself, in this case the rectangle. Hold the mouse down for a short time to show further actions. Remember that by clicking on the button once, you will activate the drawing or the action that the button is showing at that moment. If the icon shows a rectangle, you will draw a rectangle. Double-click on the button Interested to change its properties if available. While drawing your rectangle, a small gray box will appear close to your pointer, giving you width and height information about such shape you are creating. However, when you create the shape, its blue skeleton is being created as well. It has no fill but a piece of stroke. Indeed, the skeleton is the very basic structure to create your shapes, upon which you can add anything then, filling and stroke as well. Through such skeleton you will draw and edit much precisely. It is made by paths and anchors. The first ones represent the boundaries of your shape and are in light blue color, in this case. The second ones the intersection points of two different paths, and are shown in green color. Anchors represent also other hot points, for example the central point of a rectangle or points belonging to a shape's path. In case you move along a particular direction, green lines are shown by the software. If you want to draw a simple line, simply use the line segment tool or its relatives. Each artboard, so each workspace you have your drawings on, has its own layers, which are things one upon another. Go to Window and then tick Layers to open the related window. Here you can check all the layers you have. A layer is actually a collection of objects drawn, that you can see by clicking on the white arrow. Each layer has its characteristic color, which is shown through the path color of the objects inside such layer. Through this window is made a selection. Click on the right of an object to select it alone. You will recognize the objects selected through the circle on the right. If you want to select all the objects inside a single layer, just select such layer in the same way. Hold the Ctrl down while selecting to make multiple selections altogether. Notice that if the shape has no stroke or filling, it is actually invisible. You can see it by selecting it only, through its inner path. When objects will be visible, you may need to hide them on purpose. Just click on the eye on the left in the object slot. Actually, an hidden object is like a non-existing one that you can't edit or select while in this mode. You can create new layers by going to Create a new layer at the bottom. You can delete any layer or object selected by clicking on the trash button at the bottom. The new layer is recognized through a different color, and objects that will be inside will have a path of its same color. You can move an object from a layer to another simply selecting and dragging it on the new layer. To edit your objects selected, you need to use the control panel. Tick it in Windows section if you have it closed. The first color selection is made to fill the object selected. Remember that the color represented by a white icon with a red diagonal line means no color, and so deactivating the filling given to the object. The second selection is made to add stroke, whose width can be edited through the strength section. More on the right, you can further change the kind of stroke. Double-click on the kind of stroke in the list to change its properties, even in more detail. You can click on stroke as well and change caps, angles if present, or any dash and arrow on it. This does work on segments drawn too. Let's now see how to add transparency. Such is given to the object selected through the opacity option in the control panel. The percentage sets how much visible is the object selected. However, this is always applied on the whole object. In the transparency window, you find the layer masks. These are used to hide portions of the object selected. A layer mask is a defined area that hides all that is outside such space. So, transparency will be added to the whole object, but you will see just what falls inside the layer mask area. The rest is totally hidden. Click on Make Mask on the right to create the layer mask. At first it is shown totally in black, which means that you won't be able to see your object below. Click on the layer mask while holding Alt down to start editing it. The software will right show you just the extension of this mask, that you can edit just like an ordinary element drawn. When finishing, just click on the left to come back to your object to add transparency too. You will see that the visible area is just the one that is under such layer mask defined, with the current opacity level decided. If your layer mask got a nice shape that you want to convert into a normal element drawn, just click on Release. Such new element will be right added in the same layer you are working on. Go to Window and then to Gradient to start adding it to your object selected. Below the sample shown, you can choose to add a gradient to the fill or the stroke, the kind of gradient, and eventually its direction in angles and the scaling. More at the bottom, the bar sets the color fades and the colors interested. There are two indicators. The ones under the bar are used to set the color, so that what comes on the right of each indicator will acquire more and more of the color of the indicator, which can be changed double-clicking on the indicator interested. The rhombus above the bar sets the transition between two colors. If such indicator is closer to its left color, such will last less, passing from left to right. The bar representation simplifies how the colors change in the gradient applied. Going from left to right means going from one side to the other in the gradient. In Illustrator, it is very important the order of the layers, which sets the order according to which an object is shown above others or not. An object above another object in the layer list is shown on such object. So, actually, the object or layer that is first in the list is always shown above any element in your workspace. Remember that, to change the list, you can select the object interested and drag it up and down. A quick transformation can be done easily. Hold Ctrl down and click and drag an object to move it around. Scaling is done by holding Ctrl down, dragging any object's anchor. If you approach the skeleton, you will rotate the object instead. Selection is made first by holding Ctrl down always and clicking once on an element. You can select more objects in this way, belonging to the same layer or not. Otherwise, you can click and drag your mouse to create a selection area. All that falls inside such will be selected. You can cut, copy and paste an object using Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V. Delete first an object by pressing Delete key from your keyboard. In the Tools panel, you will find lots of more applications, from the more advanced selection tools to the tools to scale and rotate. Just try them. You have advanced tools to draw in Illustrator, such as the important pen tool. To start drawing professionally in Illustrator, watch the next video in this show. To zoom in and out your workspace, use the Zoom tool, indicated through the lens icon. Click on your workspace to zoom in, and hold Alt down to zoom out. To zoom a particular area, just draw the mouse on your workspace, whereas to move your workspace, you can use the End tool, or hold the Space button down. The two rectangles at the bottom of the Tools panel are the colors of the stroke and the feeling of the object selected. Choose the white rectangle with a red line to make them invisible anytime. The three icons below the color icons are used to draw behind or above existing objects. Draw normal lets you draw on existing objects. Otherwise, choose draw behind. Draw inside lets you draw within the edges of the object selected. In case you mistake any action, go to Edit and then to Undo or press Ctrl and Z. It is possible to draw freehand using paintbrush. You can draw straight segments holding Shift down in this way. Remember that such line drawing can just have a stroke and no filling. Similar is the blob brush tool. The only difference is that with this tool you have the skeleton of this object that is made through the boundaries of the brush done, and this will let you personalize better your brush itself. Plus, this blob object can have a filling as well. You can erase parts of your drawing using the Path Eraser tool. This erases the object along its skeleton, so its basic shape is not endangered. The Eraser tool acts on the wall drawing instead. Just assure that the object is selected. Scissors tool cuts the element in pieces without erasing anything. It acts working on the skeleton of the object. Knife adds new paths inside filled objects. The T icon is used for the text. Just click it and drag on your workspace to set the text box when you are going to write inside. Then you manage the text as an object. Then just save your work. Use File and go to Save As. Projects saved are under .ai formats that do keep all the layer structures saved. If you save as a .pdf, you will actually lose the layer structure of your artwork. Well, that's all. Now you have the basics to start with this software. Check our channel to get into other amazing softwares. Thanks for watching.